Good morning students. So today again we'll be talking about the same chapter that we were doing since 4-5 classes, and I hope today we'll be completing this chapter and also starting with a new unit, that is a third unit of your NCERT. We are starting with a new unit because evolution is the fourth chapter of a second unit, but it has been removed from the CBSE syllabus. That's why we have to continue with next unit, and if you are interested in studying that chapter, then we can deal with it when our syllabus is completed. So for now we'll be starting with the next unit and leaving the chapter that already has been removed, because we have to focus on our boards. So now the last topics that are left are the human genome project, as well as the second one is DNA fingerprinting. So all these are can be said as to be the advancement in the field of molecular biology, how the DNA has been used for figuring out the base pairs and then combining these different base pairs of different individuals and then determining the relationship between them. So mostly DNA fingerprinting is used in case of forensic studies, like for clearing out the disputes between in the murder cases, the hairs or the blood stains are used in, and the DNA has been extracted out from that stain, blood stain or the hair, and then we can use it for further studies by combining it with that DNA which was first found in the place where the already the crime has happened. So this is the use of DNA fingerprinting. We'll discuss in detail after the human genome project. First, human genome project, it is a very vast or mega project that was started in the year, and it completed in 13 years. So it was started in 1990 and it was then completed in the year 2003. So how long? 13 years were being invested in this mega project. So now, first of all, from where it started, the US government started the human genome project in the year 1990, and it was coordinated by the Department of Energy and the National Institutes of Health. So many of different National Institutes of Health as well as the Department of Energy were coordinated in this project, as it was very vast and it required many and many laboratories for it to be accomplished. Then genome. We have already talked about the term genome, but let's talk about it once more. The whole heredity information of an organism that is being encoded in the DNA. So जो भी जितनी भी total heredity information है जो कि pass on होती है to the next generation, वो encoded होती है in the DNA, and that complete heredity information is called as genome. So now human genome project was called a mega project, and why was it called a mega project? Because of the following reasons. The first reason was the human genome project was about of how many base pairs? 3×10⁹, that makes us billions of base pairs. So this how much base pairs was present in the human, and these have to be decoded. So it was a mega project because so many base pairs were involved in this, and the cost of sequencing required $3 per base pair. So now you can imagine $3 per base pairs, and we have to do the coding of 3×10⁹ base pairs. So the total estimated cost of the project was about $9 billion. Then the second one, why it was a mega project, the obtained sequences were to be stored in type form in books. Like if we just assume that if this whole this complete base pair information have to be stored in a type form in form of books, so how much space will it take? If each page of the book contained, if we are just assuming these things, agar her page of the book jo hai hoti hai, that will be containing 1000 letters, or each book contained 1000 pages, so then how many such books need to store that information? Still that 3300 different books were to be used for coding or storing for all these information that was of 3×10⁹ base pairs. So this is how much space it required. That's why it was a mega project. Now what were the aims of and the goals of this project? So the first and foremost aim of the project was to identify the approximate 20,000 to 25,000 genes in the human DNA. So our human DNA consists of approximately approximately 20,000 to 25,000 genes in number. So the aim was to identify all these genes, and it was a very tedious task. The second one was to determine the sequences of the 3 billion bases that make up human DNA. So as I told you, 3 into 10 to the power 9 base pairs were there, and we have to determine the sequences of all these human DNA. Then the third one was to store this information in databases. So storing this vast information was also a very tedious task, and the goal was to perform it very efficiently. Then fourth one, to improve tools for the data analysis. Many tools were not very much improved at that time in the year 1990, and some scientists were working on improving the tools so that this information can be stored in compact form. So many programs, computer programs, were being made for this process. So you can imagine how different fields were involved in this human genome project. Then the fifth one was to address the ethical, legal and social issues that arise from genome research. So now, as human genome sequencing was also an ethical issue, as they were almost trying to complete sequence of the humans, and they can also form a clone of the human. So that is an ethical issue that cannot be granted easily, because that will be very wrong, and that can be used in a very bad way also. That's why it was facing many ethical, logical as well as social issues also. Now the third one comes, the methodologies, how different methods were used for this genome project. So the methods that involved two major approaches. So what were the two major approaches that were involved in the human genome project? First one was identifying all the genes that expressed as RNA. So the genes that are expressed as RNAs are called as express sequence tags, or ESTs. So these are the genes that are expressed as RNAs, and these were being used for the human genome project, or the 3 billion base pairs of DNA sequencing. Then the second one was to the blind approach of simply sequencing the whole set of genome. So we do not know what the scientists that were doing it, that when they started, they did not know will they be able to accomplish or not, or they were starting such a vast project, will they be able to end it or not. So the approach was completely blind. They started sequencing the whole set one by one, step by step, and that contained all the coding and non-coding sequences. As I told you, in our DNA, they are present both the sequences, coding, that are the exons, and the non-coding, that are the introns. So that's why scientists ne coding start ki, wo, they cannot remove the exons at that time. That's why coding sab ki hoti chali gai, exons ki bhi, introns ki bhi. So that make it more difficult. Then what they do, they later assign different regions in the sequence with functions. So sequence annotation. So phir uske baad jab puri sequencing ho gayi, whole set ki introns aur exons sab combine ho gaye, phir assigning work start hua. To assign matlab ek a particular place, they determine ki these are the regions that are responsible for coding, and these are the regions that are non-coding regions. Then what are the salient features of the human genome project? The human genome contains 3,164.7 million nucleotide bases. This is the accurate number, that how much million nucleotide sequence bases are present in the human genome. And the average gene consists of 3,000 bases, but the sizes vary. So the size of the gene may vary. They can be of many thousand times, but this is the average we are taking. So 3,000 bases are the average. They can be many, many thousands also, but that is a very rare thing. So the largest known human gene being dystrophin. This is the largest human being gene, and that is of about 2.4 million bases. Now you can imagine the average is 3,000 bases, and ek human gene hai dystrophin jisme 2.4 million bases hai. So now you can imagine ki kuch aise bases bhi gene bhi honge jinme bases bahut hi zyada kam honge. That's why jo average hamara aa raha hai, that is only about 3,000. So now the total number of genes is estimated at 30,000. So it is lower than previous estimates of 80,000 to 1,40,000 genes. So jo total number of genes estimated the, that were about 30,000, and it is very much lower jo previous estimates that scientists made, that were about 80,000 to 1,40,000. So there was difference in the estimates made. Then almost all, about 99.9% nucleotide bases are exactly the same in all people. So how we differ? Only 0.1% is the difference in the DNA of all the people, and that makes all the differences. The functions are known for over 50% of discovered genes and less than 2% of genome codes for proteins. So there is only 2% of the genome that is coding for protein, and rest 98% is just for maintaining the structure of the gene. Now talking about the salient features, some others are repeated sequences make up very large portion of the human gene. So in human gene kuch aise sequences hote hain from some hundreds to thousand aise regions hote hain, aise sequences hote hain hamare human genome mein jo ki repeated sequence hote hain, that are also called as the satellite DNAs or the micro satellite or mini satellite DNA. So ye jo regions hote hain, these are repeated, matlab ye bahut baar repeat hote hain hamare genome mein, and that's why these repeated regions are mostly used in case of DNA fingerprinting. Now the chromosome 1 jo hota hai hamara, wo hota hai of about 2968 genes. So matlab maximum amount of genes chromosome 1 mein hote hain, aur Y jo hamara chromosome hota hai, that is in the males, that has the fewest number of chromosome, that is only about 231. So scientists have identified about 1.4 million locations where the single base DNA differences. What are the single base DNA differences? The single nucleotide polymorphism. Polymorphism is a term that is used for the repeated sequences. So jo repeat karte hain apne aapko, that are present in many areas in the DNA in the human genome, that's why they are called polymorphism, or also the short form for this is SNPs, the single nucleotide polymorphism. So scientists ne identify kiya there are about 1.54 million of locations where single base DNA differences is present. Matlab jo DNA differences hai wo sirf single base ka hai, to aisi kitni locations thi? 1.4 million. Now this information helps to finding chromosomal locations for disease associated sequencing and tracing human history. तो ये जो scientists ने find out किया कि ऐसी कुछ locations हैं जो सिर्फ single base difference से हो रही हैं between two different individuals, तो ये these were enough to find out the locations of disease that were associated sequences and tracing the human history, कि कहाँ से evolve हुए human, from which organisms and what were the first organisms. So by calculating or noting down these SNPs, the single nucleotide polymorphism जो sequences थे, इनको note down करके, इनकी analysis करके, जो different disease associated थी different chromosome से, उनका पता लगा जा सकता था और complete human history को trace किया जा सकता था. So these were the very important benefits that were of the human genome project, and that's why it was a very very important in the history of biology. Now in the DNA fingerprinting. So DNA fingerprinting was first time started or invented by Alex Jeffrey. So it is a technology that is used for the identification of individual at genetic level. So if we have to if we want to identify any individual or make this that or find out ki do individuals aapas mein kaise related hain aur kitna related hain, so that we can find out their lineage from their history, from if they are belonging to the same family or not. So we can use this DNA fingerprinting as it is identifying the individual at the genetic level. Now this technology was first time developed by Alex Jeffrey and in the year 1985, before the Human Genome Project. So DNA fingerprinting involves identifying differences in some specific regions in DNA sequence called the repetitive DNA. So as I told you ki repetitive DNA DNA fingerprinting mein use hote hain, to ye jo DNA fingerprinting hai wo inhi repetitive DNA ka use karti hai to identify the individuals and determining the closeness or differences in between the two individuals. So this is all about Alex Jeffrey, when he was born and where he studied. Now these repetitive DNA are separated from bulk genomic DNA at different peaks during density gradient centrifugation. So ye jo repetitive DNA, first what we do, पहले पूरा डीएनए हम लोग लेते हैं किसी ह्यूमन का, एंड देन वी सेंट्रीफ्यूज इट. तो एक इट इज़ एन एक्सपेरिमेंट, सेंट्रीफ्यूजेस होते हैं जो कि डीएनए को एक बहुत ही ज़्यादा हाई स्पीड पे रोटेट करते हैं, और ये जो सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन होता है यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड इन द फिजिक्स ऑल्सो. सेंट्रीफ्यूगेशन इज अ फोर्स विच इज डेवलप्ड इन द केस ऑफ सर्कुलर बॉडीज. सो दीज डी एन ए आर ऑल्सो मेड टू सेंट्रीफ्यूज और रोटेट एट अ वेरी हाई स्पीड एंड देन वॉट हैपन्स दिस रिपीटेटिव डी एन ए गेट सेपरेटेड बिकॉज दे आर अ स्लाइटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द अदर नॉर्मल डी एन ए सिक्वेंसेज. दैट्स वाई अपने आप सेपरेट हो जाते हैं. सो जो बल्क डी एन ए है दैट फॉर्म्स अ मेजर पीक और ये जो बाकी जो डी एन ए होता है अदर देन रिपीटेटिव डी एन ए ये एक बहुत बड़ा और मेजर पीक फॉर्म करता है और जो अदर स्मॉल पीक्स होते हैं दैट आर नोन एज द सेटेलाइट डी एन ए एंड सेटेलाइट डी एन ए आर द रिपीटेटिव डी एन ए. सो दैट इज हाउ वी कैन डिफ्रेंशिएट बिटवीन द बल्क जीनोम. बल्क मतलब जो ज़्यादा अमाउंट में प्रेजेंट होता है एंड द स्मॉल पीक्स आर रिफरिंग टू द सेटेलाइट डी एन ए जो कि कम अमाउंट में प्रेजेंट होते हैं एंड दे मेक ऑल द डिफरेंस. नाउ दिस सिक्वेंसेज शो हाई डिग्री ऑफ पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म एंड फॉर्म बेसिस ऑफ फिंगर प्रिंटिंग. तो ये जो सिक्वेंसेज होते हैं द रिपीटेटिव डी एन ए और द सेटेलाइट डी एन ए दे आर शोइंग वेरी मच हाई डिग्री ऑफ पॉलीमॉर्फिज्म. मतलब ये बहुत सारी जगहों पर प्रेजेंट होते हैं इन द जीनोम एंड दैट्स वाई दी मेक द बेसिस ऑफ द डी एन ए फिंगर प्रिंटिंग. सो the inheritable mutation is observed in a population at high frequency. It is referred as DNA polymorphism. So inheritable mutation होता है that inheritable mutation मतलब वो mutation जो कि generation after generation pass on हो रहा है. So that is the inheritable mutation and this inheritable mutation it is observed in a population at high frequency. तो जो भी mutation जनरेशन आफ्टर जनरेशन फाइंड आउट वी कैन फाइंड आउट और जो हाई फ्रिक्वेंसी मतलब दो तरह के म्यूटेशन अगर एक जनरेशन से दूसरे जनरेशन में पास ऑन हुए और फिर कुछ जनरेशन उसके बाद मतलब थर्ड जनरेशन में पास ऑन हुए तो वो हाई डिग्री दोज आर कॉल्ड एज द हाई डिग्री म्यूटेशंस जो कि जनरेशन आफ्टर जनरेशन पास होते हैं बिना किसी चेंजेस के. सो दीज आर द basis of polymorphism. So the sequences which show high degree of polymorphism are forming the basis of DNA fingerprinting and these inheritable mutation is observed in a population as the at high frequency and they are called as the DNA polymorphism. So these repeated DNA don't change very frequently generation after generation, that's why they are being used in the case of the case of disputes that are to be determined who is the parent of someone or who is a child of any individual. तो ये हम लोग कैसे determine कर सकते हैं इन्हीं DNA polymorphism के through. Because repetitive DNA जो होते हैं वो generation after generation easily change नहीं होते हैं, इनकी frequency कम नहीं होती है as we move on from generation to after generation. That's why ये जो repetitive DNA होते हैं हम लोग इनको compare करते हैं and on comparing we can see कि अगर ये match ज़्यादा कर रहे हैं from one to another so that we can identify that yes this is the son or this is the father of this person. Now the family the principle of the DNA fingerprinting is based on the matching of VNTRs. So what are VNTRs? The variable number of tandem repeats. Jitne zyada repetitions honge to that will be matched with the individual one and individual two or in VNTRs ko match karke we can determine the suspect at the crime spot or also the father or son or mother of a person. So these are the various advantages of the DNA fingerprinting. So VNTR is the variable number of tandem repeats. It is also called as mini satellites and they show a very high degree of polymorphism. So the DNA satellites, now again DNA satellites fits kuch types mein divide hote hain that we called as mini satellites and these mini satellites show a much higher degree of polymorphism. Matlab ye jo VNTRs hote hain ye unki jo जनरेशन आफ्टर जनरेशन जो इनहेरिटेंस की प्रॉपर्टी होती है वो और कम चेंज होती है. दैट्स वाई दे आर बेस्ट फॉर डिटरमाइनिंग और बींग यूज इन द डी एन ए फिंगर प्रिंटिंग एंड द वी एन टी आर्स द वेरिएबल नंबर ऑफ टैंडम रिपीट्स आर वेरी स्पेसिफिक टू इंडिविजुअल एंड डिफर्स फ्रॉम पर्सन टू पर्सन एंड इट शोज सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन फैमिली मेम्बर्स. तो जो 0.1% डिफरेंस आता है दीज आर मेनली बिकॉज ऑफ द सेटेलाइट डी एन एस एंड द वी एन टी आर. सो ये जो वी एन टी आर्स है ये डिटरमाइन करते हैं that who is a family member of which person. So VNTRs sirf identical twins ka same hota hai, hence it is not possible to identify individuality in identical twins by DNA fingerprinting technology. So jo VNTRs DNA fingerprinting technology hai ye sirf fail karti hai only in the case of identical twins because they have the same or identical means completely same variable number of tandem repeats. Now, what is southern blotting? It is a technique of transferring DNA from agar gel to nylon sheet, and these are the various techniques that are used in the case of DNA fingerprinting. We will talk about it in the next diagram. So what is probe? Probe is any single-stranded polynucleotide fragment complementary to the specific sequence of nucleotides of DNA is called probe. So agar hum kisi DNA ko study kar rahe hain, to we have to label it. Aur us labeling ke liye hum log ek probe ko use karte hain. Labeling kyun zaruri hai? Taki hum log ko ye pata chal sake ki hum log isi part ko study kar rahe hain. That's why we have to label it with a single-stranded polynucleotide fragment which is complementary with that पोर्शन जो हम लोग स्टडी कर रहे हैं. अगर वो कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री नहीं होगा तो वो बाइंड नहीं करेगा, एंड दैट्स वाई वी कैन नॉट बी एबल टू अप्लाई दैट प्रोब टू द डीएनए सेगमेंट दैट वी आर स्टडिंग. सो इट इज मेनली यूज इन आइडेंटिफाई वीएनटीआरस एंड द डिजायर जीन. नाउ द स्टेप्स दैट आर इन्वॉल्व इन द डीएनए फिंगरप्रिंटिंग टेक्नोलॉजी. दिस इज अ सेंस सैंपल. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल दे आर टेकिंग द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ लीफ. यहाँ से एक पूरा सैंपल है, कंसिडर लीफ. देन वन सेल इज बींग टेकन आउट और इस सेल से we extracted the DNA. Then what is being happened? The DNA is being cleaved or being broken down by restriction enzyme. So the restriction enzymes are restriction endonuclease or exonuclease. They are for breaking down the DNA into two different fragments. Endonuclease beech mein se break karta hai and exonuclease from the ends. Now what is being done? Separation of the DNA fragments by electrophoresis. Electrophoresis is a method which is used for separating DNA fragments, because जो DNA fragments VNTRs होते हैं वो तेज़ी से move करते हैं when the electricity or the when the cells or battery is being applied. तो electro word is used for in that cases or fluoresces the movement. So this is being done when the DNA segments have to be distinguished from one another, और VNTRs जो होते हैं वो जल्दी move करते हैं. That's why दो different nodes बन जाते हैं, positive and negative. In the chemistry you must have studied that in the battery condition. So जो VNTRs होते हैं वो अपने आप अलग हो जाते हैं from the bulk DNA. Now what is being done? This is being transferred to a membrane. This is southern blotting. Southern blotting was the technique of transferring DNA from agar gel to nylon sheet. अब जो nylon sheet पे agar gel से हमने transferring की है of the DNA, that is called as southern blotting, and it is mainly used for the extraction of DNA. Now what is happening? The binding of the radioactive DNA probe to specific DNA fragments. Radioactive क्यों use करते हैं हम लोग? So that we can easily identify that particular part which we have to study, and that's why radioactive probes, which are single-stranded polynucleotide strand, they are being used and attached or being bind to the area that we have to study. So agar wo complementary honge tabhi they will bind. Then the membrane being washed and free of excess probe. So ye after बाइंडिंग, तो ये जो अब द सेकेंड स्टेप है उसमें वॉशिंग की जाती है. वॉशिंग की होती है जो कि एक्स्ट्रा प्रोब है जो कि हम लोग ने यूज़ किया था फॉर लेबलिंग, उसको हटाने के लिए, और ओनली दैट अमाउंट शुड बी लेफ्ट जो कि हमें रिक्वायर्ड है. देन एक्सरे फिल्म्स आर बीइंग यूज्ड टू डिटेक्ट द रेडियो एक्टिव पैटर्न. और ये जो रेडियो एक्टिव पैटर्न है, दिस इज़ हाउ इट लुक्स. सो इन द डिटेल यू कैन सी इट. प्लांट ए, दिस इज़ द प्लांट. तो ये ओरिजिनल सिक्वेंस है. अब सैम्पल एंड प्लांट बी, ठीक है. तो इस सैम्पल से जो ईजिली मैच करेगा तो देन वी कैन नो कि ये उसको ये जो सैम्पल लिया था हमने, ये प्लांट ए है या प्लांट बी है. तो इस आप बैंडिंग से वी कैन नाउ ईजिली कैलकुलेट द बैंडिंग ऑफ प्लांट बी इज़ कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द सैम्पल, एंड प्लांट ए इज शोइंग कम्प्लीट सिमिलैरिटी विद द सैम्पल. दैट्स वाई द टू प्लांट दैट वी हैव टेकन अमंग देम, द प्लांट ए इज़ द वन दैट वी आर स्टडिंग. सो दिस इज़ हाउ इट इज़ बींग डन. Now again one more case, if there is some parental dispute that have to be solved, so we take two chromosome, one from parental chromosome and maternal chromosome, paternal and maternal. Now this is father's and this is mother's. Now chromosome 7, this is the different you can see the chromosome 7, chromosome 2 and chromosome 16. Now what we have to do, this is the DNA that was being taken from the क्राइम साइट और द क्राइम सीन. तो जो भी ब्लड या हेयर मिला होगा वहाँ से, उसका ये डीएनए एक्सट्रैक्ट किया गया. अब इसको हमें कंबाइन करना है कि ये किससे ईजिली मैच कर रहा है. तो ये सी बना जो कि क्राइम साइट पे से था, ये ए फ्रॉम इंडिविजुअल ए एंड फ्रॉम बी. नाउ यू कैन सी कि जो सी का पैटर्न है दैट इज़ matching with the B1. So that's why the person who was there at the crime scene was person B, not person A. This is how the banding pattern or the DNA fingerprinting helps in determining so many problems. Now, the DNA fingerprinting technique involves southern blot and hybridization using radio-labeled PNTR as a probe. It included first step is acylation of DNA, second is digestion of DNA by restriction endonucleases, then separation of DNA fragments by electrophoresis, then transferring or blotting. Blotting matlab transferring of the separated DNA fragments to the nylon sheath, then hybridization using labeled VNTR probe. Hybridization matlab kisi aur different DNA ko ek different DNA mein combine karna. So that probe is the another DNA that we are using, and the one DNA which is the sample DNA uske complementary ek probe hume dhoondna hai. So that's why jab do different DNAs ko combine karenge, that is called hybridization. Now, detection of hybridized DNA fragments by autoradiography. Now, what are the applications? Let's talk about the applications. It is used to identify the criminals and rapists, to solve parental disputes, to solve immigrant problems, to identify dead bodies of soldiers died in wars, to identify dead bodies of person died at accidents and bomb blasts too. So all these are the different, to detect donor cell in case of transplantation. So these are the different types of uses or applications of the DNA fingerprinting. Now for the next chapter we will be talking, or the next unit is the strategies that are being used in the enhancement of food production. So these are the different animals that are used in the animal husbandry. So animal husbandry is mainly for increasing the production of whatever the things they produce, like for cows they produce milk, hens they produce eggs. So this is for enhancing that production by using some techniques of biology. So we'll talk about those techniques. What is animal husbandry now? So animal husbandry is the agricultural practice of breeding and raising the livestock. So raising of these animals that are being used in the case of providing some essential things for the human beings are the livestock, and the agricultural practice of breeding and raising them is called as animal husbandry. Now what it deals with? It deals with care and breeding of livestock like buffaloes, cows, pigs, horses, cattle, sheep, camels, goats, etc. So this is the different animals that the livestock deals with. Now extended form includes poultry farming and fisheries. So pehle in the previous days, old days, sirf ye use hote the in the case of breeding and livestock mein these animals. Then it was animal husbandry was expanded because everything have to be extended at some or the other time as the science advanced in its field, and therefore fisheries and poultry farming was also included. Fisheries include rearing, catching, selling, etc. of fishes. Mollusks are those phylum, the molluscans that are having shell around them. Then crustaceans that include prawns and crabs. So these all were being used. The different steps were rearing them, then catching them. Rearing means increasing their production, then catching them, and then selling them into the market for different purposes. So now talking next about the management of farms and farm animals. So what are the different management that are being under the category of farms and farming animals? Dairy farm management, then poultry farm. In dairy farm comes on what does come under the dairy farm management? The production of milk, the increasing production of milk due to the increasing demand of it. Then poultry farming, the increasing in the egg production. Then beekeeping or apiculture, increasing the honey production by rearing honeybees. And then fisheries. Then animal breeding objectives. What are the different objectives? What are the different reasons why we need to do this, and why is this being practiced so much nowadays? So improved growth rate, so that the growth rate is improved. And then the increased production, जो production जो भी हो रहा है वो milk produce कर रहे हैं, egg produce कर रहे हैं, या they are being used for meat, or they are giving some other things like honey, silk, all these things. तो इसके लिए उनका increased production. Then improve the desirable quality. So we can also use the hybridization methods. मतलब एक हम लोग superior quality को inferior quality या दो superior qualities को हम लोग hybrid उनका बना के by doing the cross breeding or cross fertilization, we can get the improved or desirable qualities. सो देन इम्प्रूव रेजिस्टेंस टू डिजीजेज, तो हम लोग डिजीज़ फ्री एनिमल्स को यूज़ कर सकते हैं और उनका प्रोडक्शन बढ़ा सकते हैं बाई रेगुलर क्रॉस ब्रीडिंग. देन इम्प्रूव रेजिस्टेंस टू एडवर्स इन्वायरमेंटल कंडीशंस. सो दीज आर द एम्स दैट वी हैव टू फुलफिल इन ऑर्डर टू गुड गेट अ गुड प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ऑल द डिफरेंट थिंग्स लाइक मिल्क, एग्स एंड मीट. Now the dairy farm management. Dairying, it is the management of animals for milk and its products for human consumption. Then dairy farm management, we can deal with the processes and systems that increase yield and improve quality of milk. So not just we have to increase the production, hum log milk ka production sirf increase nahi karna hai, but hum log ko uski quality bhi improve karna hai aur jo uske derivatives hain jo hum log ko milk se milta hai, so that unki bhi quality improve ho. Then for that purpose what is being done, selection of good breeds then having which are having high yielding potential. To un breeds ko hum log sabse pehle use karte hain jinki milk yielding potential high hoti hai. Then it is being combined with resistance to the disease is very important. To ab unko hum log unse cross karenge, jaise ek cow hai uski bahut zyada which it is a very good breed, uski jo milk production ability hai wo bahut zyada hai, so we'll then combine it with that or hybridize it with that cow jiski disease resistant power achhi hai. So then such a cattle have to be house well, should also have adequate water and be maintained disease free. So is sabko hum log ko pehle apply karna padega, then only we'll get a very healthy cow which will give us a good and improved quality of milk. Then the feeding of the cattle should be carried out in a scientific manner. मतलब quality and quantity of fodder जो होता है वो भी maintain करना है, कि not just quality अच्छा हम लोग को सिर्फ खाना नहीं देना है, but उसके साथ साथ we have to also give the appropriate quantity so that it does not eat a lot or it does not get malnutrition. That's why we have to maintain that also. Then stringent cleanliness and hygiene are very important while milking. Storage and transport of the milk and its products also have to be taken care of very well. Then regular visit by a veterinary doctor would be mandatory. So these are the very easy steps that are being used in the dairy farm management. Then comes the poultry farm management. So what is poultry? It is a class of domesticated fowl used for food or for their eggs. So these are mainly the using of fowl for their food. They are used for the production of meat as well as they are also being raised up for the production of eggs. Then selection of the disease free and suitable breeds, proper and safe farm conditions, proper feed and water, hygiene, healthcare are important components of poultry farm management. Then the animal breeding. A group of animals related by descent and similar in most characters like general appearance, features, size, configuration, etc. are said to be a breed. So what is a breed? Jo animals aapas mein related hote hain, descent matlab from their evolutionary point of view, jo ek dusre se related hote hain aur jo bahut sare characters mein similar hote hain, not same but similar, like जनरल अपेयरेंस उनका काफ़ी सिमिलर होता है, फीचर्स साइज सेम होता है, कन्फिग्रेशन सिमिलर होता है. सो दैट्स वाई दिस ऑल दिस ऑर्गेन एनिमल्स आर कॉल्ड एज अ वन ब्रीड एनिमल. देन एनिमल ब्रीडिंग एम्स आर इंक्रीजिंग द यील्ड ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड इम्प्रूविंग द डिज़ायर्ड क्वालिटीज ऑफ द प्रोड्यूस. जो भी बन रहा है उसका जो हम लोग को क्वालिटी है और जो डिज़ायरेबल क्वालिटी है वो हम लोग उसमें इंड्यूस कर पाएँ और उसको मेंटेन कर पाएँ. दैट इज़ व्हाट अबाउट एनिमल ब्रीडिंग इज फोकसिंग ऑन. देन व्हेन एनिमल ब्रीडिंग इज़ बिटवीन एनिमल्स ऑफ द सेम ब्रीड इट इज़ कॉल्ड एज इंटर ब्रीडिंग. और जो क्रॉसेस होते हैं डिफरेंट टू डिफरेंट ब्रीड्स के बीच में जो कि सिमिलर नहीं है एक दूसरे से, उनका डिसेंट सेम नहीं है, तो उसको हम कहते हैं आउट ब्रीडिंग. सो दिस इज़ द डिफरेंस बिटवीन इन ब्रीड एंड आउट ब्रीड. नाउ व्हाट इज़ इन ब्रीडिंग? It refers to the mating of more closely related individuals within the same breed for 4 to 6 generations. So, 4 to 6 generations तक हम what we do, we do the mating of more closely related individuals. Those are belonging to the same breed. जो general appearance जिनका same होता है, जिनका descent same होता है, उनको हम लोग 4 to 6 generations तक breed करेंगे. और जो breeding strategy है which what we will consider it in, जो मेल होगा वो सुपीरियर होगा फीमेल्स और आल्सो सुपीरियर, और जो दोनों होंगे वो सेम ब्रीड के होंगे, then they are identified and mated in pairs. Now inbreeding increases homozygosity. Homozygosity, we have studied in the genetics chapter. Homozygous means जो similar genes हैं वो it will continue to be produced. मतलब अगर उनमें they have a gene for height, so consider it TT. तो जो उनका TT condition है height की, वो continuously आगे बढ़ती जाएगी, तो उसमें कोई डिफरेंसेस नहीं आएगा. एंड एज वी नो कि वेरिएशन के बिना कोई भी एवोल्यूशन पॉसिबल नहीं है. दैट्स वाई इंटरब्रीडिंग और इनब्रीडिंग इज़ नॉट अ वेरी गुड थिंग. हाउएवर कंटिन्यूड इनब्रीडिंग, स्पेशली क्लोज इनब्रीडिंग, यूजली रिड्यूसेस फर्टिलिटी और प्रोडक्टिविटी को, क्योंकि कोई डिफरेंसेस नहीं आएगा, कोई नया जीन नहीं इंट्रोड्यूस होगा, तो इनमें जो आफ्टर सम पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम जो इनकी फर्टिलिटी है और प्रोडक्टिविटी है वो कम हो जाएगी. एंड दिस इज़ कॉल्ड एज इनब्रीडिंग डिप्रेशन. इनब्रीडिंग डिप्रेशन मतलब the sudden decline in the productivity and fertility. Then whenever this problem this becomes a problem, then selected animals of the breeding population should be mated with unrelated. Now ek bar humne dekha ki aapas mein breed karwane se in breeding depressions ki problem aa rahi hai. That's why now under the step that was started were called as the outbreeding, and this was mating between the different animals of different descents or not related animals. So this usually helps to restore the fertility and the yield as well. Now what is outbreeding? So outbreeding, it is the breeding of the unrelated animals, which may be between individuals of the same breed or between different breeds of different species. So hum log jo differences hain wo bahut hi zyada had tak cause kar sakte hain, matlab not just breed चेंज कर सकते हैं बल्कि स्पीशीज़ भी चेंज कर सकते हैं, बट मोस्ट ऑफ देम हैव नॉट बीन सक्सेसफुल. लाइक दिस इज़ द डायग्राम, यू कैन सी अ लाइगर, मतलब एक टाइगर और लायन का हाइब्रिड. सो दिस इज़ अ लाइगर, बट वी कैन नॉट सी इट वेरी फ्रिक्वेंटली, एंड दैट्स वाई दिस वर ऑल्सो नॉट वेरी मच सक्सेसफुल. सो दिस इज़ अ हाइब्रिड ऑफ हॉर्स एंड ज़ेब्रा. इट वॉज कॉल्ड अ हेब्रा. सो दिस आर द सम ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स दैट वर बींग experimented upon and not very much used. Now outcrossing. What is outcrossing? This is the practice of mating of animals within the same breed but having no common ancestors on either side of their pedigree up to 4 to 6 generations. मतलब outcrossing, we call outcrossing to that जहाँ पर breeding तो होती है, same जो mating होती है वो same breed में होती है, but जो इनके ancestors थे, मतलब हम लोग ने inbreeding में common descent की बात की थी. तो descent is related to evolution, to the history of that animal. But यहाँ पर जो animals हम लोग mate करवा रहे हैं वो होंगे same breed के, but जो उनके common ancestors होंगे वो they were not at all similar and they do not share any common ancestors, और 4 to 6 generations तक जो उनका pedigree analysis किया जाता है वो बिल्कुल same नहीं होगा. That's why it is called as outcrossing, and the offspring of such a mating is known as a outcross. So जो इनका जो प्रोड्यूस होगा ऑफस्प्रिंग, दैट विल ऑल्सो बी कॉल्ड एज एन आउटक्रॉस, एंड अ सिंगल आउटक्रॉस विल हेल्प टू ओवरकम इनब्रीडिंग डिप्रेशन. तो एक बार अगर आउटक्रॉस करवा देंगे हम लोग इनब्रीडिंग डिप्रेशन करवाने के बाद, तो वो जो इनफर्टिलिटी और द इनब्रीडिंग डिप्रेशन डेवलप हुआ था ड्यू टू कंटिन्यूड इनब्रीडिंग, उसको भी हम लोग ओवरकम कर सकते हैं ड्यू टू दिस आउटक्रॉस, बिकॉज यहाँ पर सम चेंजेस आ रहे हैं. दो इट इज़ फ्रॉम द सेम ब्रीड येट द कॉमन एंसेस आर डिफरेंट, तो कुछ ना कुछ जीन उनके डिफरेंट होंगे. नाउ क्रॉस ब्रीडिंग. In this method, the superior males of one breed are mated with superior males of females of another breed. तो एक breed का superior males will take, and from another breed will take the superior females. Now crossbreeding allows the desirable qualities of two different breeds to be combined. तो अब यहाँ पर क्या होगा, जो भी desirable qualities होंगे from one breed to another breed, वो सब दोनों हम लोग को मिल जाएंगे from that both breeds, because हम लोग दो different breeds के superior animals ले रहे हैं. And the progeny hybrid animals may themselves be used for commercial production. तो अब ये जो होंगे जो crossbreed का result होगा, that is very good, and this will be used for the commercial purposes. Now for example, this Hisardale is a new breed of sheep developed in Punjab, and what it is made by crossing Bikaneri Avis and Merino Ram. So this is the two different animals or breeds that are being used to produce this breed, because it was not very woolly like this, and it was being very light in weight, because it was having a problem in movement, as well as this was not very much having wool. So this overcame both these problems, and now this is used for commercial purposes. So this is how the different crossing and readings will help us to maintain the vigor of the animal that is we are producing, and we can also maintain a good quality of the whatever the products we are required, either it could be milk or egg. So now the next part of the chapter we'll be doing in the next section.